So this video is going to show you how to perform the two independent non-parametric tests in R. So the test that we learned for this analysis is Mann Whitney U test. In R, the command for this test is Wilkerson test. Okay, so this is a command for the independent sample. So as usual, what we need to put, we need to write the name of our object, choose the variables, the response variable, which is in this case is the weight of the apple. So you have two groups, so you want to test the differences of this measurement against the two types of apple. So the color of the apple. So this is a two independent sample. We can just click run. Okay. And in this case, we will get our test statistic. So as long as the p-value is smaller than 0.05 or any alpha that we set, then we will reject the null hypothesis. For the pair sample, to test the difference between the right and left arm, so we can load the data, we can plot the chart, so this is how it looks like. So for the pair sample, the command for the test is the same, it's a Wilkerson test. So in this case, we need to put the first variable, which is the right arm, followed by a comma, because we keep the variable separately in different column. Put the left arm length. As this is a pair sample, we have to specify the test is for the pair sample. Just type pair equal true. Then click run. So in this case, we are not going to reject the null hypothesis because our p-value is larger than alpha. The alpha that we set is 0.05. So when you perform the calculation manually, you will get a different statistical score. Okay? But it doesn't really matter as long as the conclusion is still the same as the tutorial that you have calculated manually. So as you can see, for the non-parametric two sample test, the command for the independent and the paired sample is the same, which is a Wilkerson test. But for the independent sample, the default is the false. So we don't have to type this because the default is the false. But if you use the Wilkerson test for the paired sample, you have to specify the pair is equal to true.